Like I mentioned, this is a special presentation session where we'll have IP experts share with us their expertise on two different topics. We first have a presentation on how startups and MSMEs can protect their IP rights in the most economical and fastest way. This presentation is by Mr. Vivek Singh, IP attorney and head IP prosecution practice at Sagacious IP. And without wasting any time, I'll invite him on stage to make his presentation.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank SOCHAM for arranging this session on IP excellence and arranging the awards and then inviting me to talk about how startups and MSMEs can file their IP rights in the most economical way and in the quickest way. So in next 15 minutes, I'll talk about only three points. Number one is filing of patent, trademark and designs in India and globally and getting these registered very, very quickly. Number two, cost involved in getting these filed in India and globally. And point number three, how to minimize the cost and even how to get the IP protections done for free. So these are the three points I'll be talking about. First, let's talk about the first point, how to file the patent applications and get these granted in a very quicker way. Under this point, I'll have just four minor or the sub points. The point number one is importance of the well-drafted patent application. So everyone is aware about filing the patents and even the quality of patents. So I will talk about another perspective of why it is important to file well-drafted patent applications. Number two is choosing between the convention route or the Paris Convention route or the PCT route. What are the differences between these two routes? When to opt for one and when to opt for the second. Third is how to get your applications granted in a very quicker way, expedited examination or fast track examination. When to do that and when not to do that. And then cost estimates. I'll be sharing the cost estimates for all these activities. So point number one, importance of well-drafted patent application. So in this point, I will highlight one important point, and that is patent law is based upon the barter system. Ye samajhna bahut zaruri hai, because only then you will be able to understand the quality of drafting and filing good patent applications. So barter system, clear hai? What is the barter system? Can anyone please answer? Give and take. Very simple fundamental. So this is the rationale behind the patent law. When there was not the patent law, so kya hota tha? Jo inventors ya jo creators the, so they used to keep their know-hows, their technical know-hows with themselves only. And when they die so all these technical things will remain with them. So just to promote the concept of disclosing their inventions, their know-hows to public, the patent law was introduced. So it was the basic rationale behind the patent law, wherein you have to disclose your invention. The inventors or the applicants have to disclose their invention. So that is the give which you are giving to public. So in return, you must have or you should have to receive something in order to that barter system getting functional. So milta kya hai return mein? Any idea? Aapko 20 years ki monopoly milti hai. The day your patent is granted, so from the date of filing till the expiry, 20 years ki patent applicant ko monopoly milti hai. So this is what you get. You are giving or you are disclosing your invention, so that is what you are giving. In return, you are getting the monopoly. Now suppose the scenario wherein you have filed a poorly drafted application. You have drafted by yourself or maybe any R&D scientist, but not by the expert. Us case mein hoga kya? Barter system ke tahat aap apni invention to disclose kar chuke ho. What you are supposed to give, you have given, you have disclosed your invention in the patent application, right? But what you are supposed to get in return will be gone, because patent office will refuse that application, that this patent is not getting a grant. So you have given, you have disclosed your invention, but you are not getting the return. This is the importance of filing a good patent application, a well-drafted patent application, so that whatever you are giving, you can also get the return under the barter system. Here the prior art is very, very mandatory. Many of the clients are coming to us and they say that you just file the application, there is no need to do or conduct the prior art. Ab ek cheez batao, aapne koi property khareedi hai kisi ne? Kisne property khareedi hai? बहुतों ने हमने सबने खरीदी है, आप प्रॉपर्टी कभी भी विदाउट चेकिंग कि ये किसी और के नाम पे रजिस्टर्ड तो नहीं है, किसी और ने इसको खरीद तो नहीं रखा, प्रॉपर्टी खरीदते हो गया नहीं, वी डू अ सर्वे, यू हैव अप्लाइड फॉर द लोन्स ऑन योर बिहाफ, बैंक डू द सेम, दे गेट द सर्वे डन इफ द प्रॉपर्टी इज अवेलेबल फॉर रजिस्ट्रेशन और नॉट. And this is for all the properties, not only for patent. I will cover the trademark part also. So, जब property आप खरीदने के लिए आप survey कर रहे हो, so why not for intellectual property? It means when you are filing the patent application, first get the exhaustive patent search done. That will clarify the thing if that patent is available for filing or it's good to go for invention or not. Patents are being filed for marketing tool also. I will cover that aspect also, but that should be an informed decision from the beginning itself. So, ye do points maine cover kare, barter system and the importance of prior art. Now, coming to the second part, choosing between the convention route or the Paris Convention route and the PCT route. When you have the invention, it's the your prototyping, everything is done, and the I am supposing that your invention is good to go for filing a complete or non-provisional application. You have filed, but your market of interest or the countries of interest are not clear. So in that scenario, after filing the patent application, the PCT application is supposed to be filed. Then you will be getting another 18 months to decide upon the countries of interest. But if the market of interests are clear and these are just one or two, just aapko ye lag raha hai ki meri invention is, I will hardly go to US or Europe. So then there is no need to file the PCT application. Within 1 year, you can choose the Paris Convention route and file the corresponding national phase applications. 18 months ka time is very important. In the scenario wherein you are not clear about your countries of interest. In the PCT filing, there is a lot of cost difference. I have covered some basic official fee here. For example, filing in India is very simple if you are a startup, MSME, academic institution of a certain category or individual, the official fee is just 1600, for others it's 8000. When you are filing the PCT application for companies, it's approximately 1,10,000 rupees. I am talking about only the official fee. But if you are an individual or if you are filing the application under your name and you are an Indian resident, so there is a 90% reduction in the official fee and the applicable official fee will remain just 12,500 approximately. Seeing the difference between a PCT application filed by the individual vis-a-vis the company. If you are one single a single founder or you are running a small startup and you are the sole founder of that company, so you can opt for filing the application under your name. Later on you can get the transfer once the investments and everything are done, but in the beginning you will be able to save a lot of money in terms of what you will be paying to government or the WIPO for as the official fee. This is the one strategy you can use. It's a huge difference. Now I have covered the official fee of around 9-10 countries just to give an idea about how much you will have to spend in case you will be filing the corresponding national phase applications. So these are the official fee. Again, the professional fee will vary a lot. For example, in US, if you are filing the corresponding application, the Paris Convention or the PCT national phase, professional fee will vary from $100 and up to $1,500, depending upon the firm you are choosing, depending upon the attorney you are choosing. So here is a small trick which I would like to share. In the filing work, so I said the fee will range in the professional fee between $100 to $1,500. Filing work is only the paralegal work, जिसमें lawyer, US attorney कुछ नहीं का कोई role नहीं है. It is just a paralegal work. Here you can choose a firm or attorney which is on the lower side of the filing fee. Later on that application can be prosecuted by the expert in that domain. But in the beginning you can save a lot of money because filing will not require or the paralegal work will not require the attorney's skills. So on that front, you can save a lot of money. When the office action will come, so you can get the office actions drafted by Indian firms, finalized by the US firm and filed by them. So these are the tricks which you can use, strategies you can use to minimize the cost for US filing, Europe filing, Canada filing. At least in the English countries, you can minimize the cost to the minimum possible. Now I will quickly touch upon the fee for expedited examination. Here I would like to emphasize on one single fact. Every application is not deserving to go for fast track examination. Why? Fast track examination is a double edged sword. Speed road side laga hota hai. Speed thrills, but sare log jaag rahe hai na, but kills. So fast track examination ka ek benefit bhi hai ki your application will get the grant in a very quicker way, but on the other side it will be rejected by the patent office. So if your application is not, or invention is not that much peculiar to get the grant, so you can discuss with your attorney and file the request for examination towards the end of the 48 months, because you can, till that time, you can use that invention, that application number as the marketing tool. Patents are not only used as the legal tool, these are used as the marketing tool also. So choose very, very carefully which application is supposed to go for fast track examination and which should not go. Okay, all right. So I have covered the, these are the fee which are associated for early publication, normal request for examination and fast track examination. Coming to the second part, the trademark. 4 points again, the fundamentals of the trademark law, importance of trademark availability search. Third, choosing between the conventional route, the Paris conventional route or the Madrid route. And finally, the cost estimates. अच्छा, ट्रेडमार्क लॉ इज बेस्ड अपॉन विच वन लाइनर फंडामेंटल? पैटेंट वॉज बेस्ड ऑन द बार्टर सिस्टम, ट्रेडमार्क इस फंडामेंटल पे बेस्ड है. इन वन सिंगल लाइन आई कैन कवर द 90% ऑफ द ट्रेडमार्क लॉ. एक ही लाइन का कॉन्सेप्ट है ट्रेडमार्क लॉ का. वो क्या है? कैन एनी वन प्लीज आंसर? ट्रेडमार्क लॉ इज बेस्ड अपॉन वन सिंगल कॉन्सेप्ट, एंड दैट इज टू डिफ्रेंशिएट बिटवीन द प्रोडक्ट्स और सर्विसेज ऑफ वन पर्सन फ्रॉम अदर्स. इस लाइन में ट्रेडमार्क का पूरा 90% कॉन्सेप्ट कवर हो जाता है. ट्रेडमार्क कैसे चूज करना है, कौन सा ट्रेडमार्क चूज करना है, कैसे उसको क्विकली रजिस्टर करना, आई हैव अ स्लाइड फॉर दैट, आई विल क्विकली कवर दैट. बट अगेन, इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ ट्रेडमार्क सर्च इज इक्वली इंपॉर्टेंट एज यू हैव डन फॉर द प्रायर आर्ट सर्च फॉर पैटर्न्स. बिफोर फाइलिंग द ट्रेडमार्क सर्च इज अ मस्ट. And not only in India, in all the countries where you are thinking of to file the trademark application, because any mark might be available in India, but not in other countries and vice versa. So there are trademark searches which are supposed to be done. There are many clients who file the applications, and then when they have done the branding and everything, that mark is known in the market, then they come to us and request for filing. And that trademark is either registered by someone else or it is a very, very generic mark or descriptive mark. So, वो scenario में नहीं आना है, आपको पहले search करनी है in all the countries of interest, and then you file and then choose, you have to go for Madrid route or the conventional route. If you have more than 5 countries, then it's a good idea to go for Madrid, otherwise you can choose the traditional route. So in this slide, I have covered the whole trademark law. अगर ये स्लाइड समझ आ गई, so trademark law समझ आ गया. So I have divided the category of trademarks into 5 brackets. The higher category is very easy to register. The lowest category is very, very difficult to register. For companies, startups and MSMEs, बेहतर है कि आप ऊंची वाली रैंक में ही जाओ. And if you have a lot of money, well-funded startup, पैसे की कोई कमी नहीं है, and you have money to give to lawyers, then आप नीचे वाली category में भी जा सकते हो. That you have to choose. The first and most strongest category is called as fanciful and coined words. थोड़ा technical, इसको मैं simplified version बता रहा हूँ. कोई भी ऐसा word choose कर लो जिसका dictionary में meaning नहीं है, that is a good trademark. Provided no one else has opted for that trademark. कि एक लाइन का सिंपल कॉन्सेप्ट है ट्रेडमार्क का. एक ऐसा वर्ड चूज करो जो दिमाग में आए, उसका डिक्शनरी में एंट्री नहीं है, सो दैट इज अ गुड ट्रेडमार्क. द लिटमस टेस्ट, ऑफ कोर्स आफ्टर दैट यू हैव टू गेट द ओपिनियन फ्रॉम द ट्रेडमार्क अटर्नी कि अवेलेबल है रजिस्ट्रेशन के लिए कि नहीं. एग्जाम्पल्स आर कोडैक. डिक्शनरी मीनिंग है क्या कोई? कैन एनीवन टेल अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ कोडैक? नहीं. गूगल का कोई मीनिंग है क्या डिक्शनरी? नहीं है. सो दिस इज द हाईएस्ट कैटेगरी ऑफ मार्क. So choose in that case. Arbitrary marks are, jinka meaning to hai. If you go for the meaning of Apple, what they are selling is not related to the name. So they are selling computers and mobile phones. So there is no relation between Apple and computer. Ab ye mat kehna ki Apple kha gaya banda intelligent ho jayega, healthy hoga, acche se computer use karega. There is no direct correlation. Dove, it's a name of a bird. But ye logic aap laga sakte ho ki dove laga ke you can be softer like a bird. That there is no direct correlation. Suggestive marks are Netflix, jo name indicate kar raha hai, Airbus. Descriptive marks are sugar free, very very difficult to register, delivery. And generic marks, I'm not talking about the generic trademarks which have become generic like Xerox or Delta. I'm talking about the generic terms. Agrawal Sweet House, Mehta Sadi House sort of name should not be opted for. This is a slide covering the fee, official fee for filing trademark. First, India, 45 rupees official fee hai. Trademark attorney ki fee 2000 se 25000 tak vary karti. Again, you can choose carefully. Official fee for Madrid filing and direct filing, almost similar, but farak kahan pe hai? Professional fee. Madrid jab aap file karoge, there will be only one of professional fee, that will be just 50 to 200 USD. But if you are filing the direct applications, then for each country there will be $100 to $1,500. You are getting the point. Choosing between design and patent is another very important concept. Suppose you have developed a helmet, a very unique shaped helmet. You can only go for design filing. Design filing is very, very straightforward, very economical, very simple. Maybe aapko patent karne ki zarurat nahi hai because there is no functionality involved with it. So you have to choose carefully between the filing of the patent or design or both. And the last and very important point, how you can get your IP protection done for free. So there are many schemes. Suppose agar aaj shaam ko 8 baje government ka ek announcement aaye, rashtra ke naam sambodhan, aur usme ye bola jaye aaj raat 12 baje ke baad se jo bhi property register hogi uska reimbursement aapko sarkar se mil jayega. Property ki baat kar raha hu. What will happen tomorrow? तहसील जहाँ पे रजिस्ट्री होती है, लाइन लग जाएगी जिनके भी प्रॉपर्टी पेंडिंग होगी कि फटाफट रजिस्टर करा लो, स्कीम बंद ना हो जाएगी. द सेम सिचुएशन इज ऑलरेडी देयर फॉर इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी, वेयर इन गवर्नमेंट इज सेइंग यू फाइल योर इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी, गेट एवरीथिंग रिइंबर्स्ड फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट. बट फिर भी लोगों को अवेयरनेस नहीं है. अगर इसके बाद भी अगर आप आईपी एप्लीकेशंस नहीं फाइल कर रहे हो, वेयर इन आईपी विल रिमेन विद यू बट गवर्नमेंट विल बियर द कॉस्ट, तो इसमें गलती आपकी है. आर दी स्कीम्स, देयर आर मेनी स्कीम्स. एसआईपीपी स्कीम है डीपीआईआईटी की, मेटी की स्कीम है फॉर आईसीटी रिलेटेड स्टार्टअप्स, एमएसआईएनएस महाराष्ट्र इनोवेशन स्टेट सोसाइटी की एक स्कीम है, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एमएसएमई की स्कीम है विच इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अंडर दैट स्कीम इफ यू आर फाइलिंग अ पैटेंट इन इंडिया यू कैन गेट अप टू 1 lakh रुपी for per patent. Foreign patent up to 5 lakhs per patent. If you are filing one patent in 10 countries, you can get multiplied by 5, 50 lakhs. So that is the amount Ministry of MSME is giving for IP registration. Trademark up to 10,000 per trademark. Design 15,000 per design application. And there are many other schemes by the state governments also. So this was all from my side. Thank you everyone. In case you have any further query, here are my contact details. In case you have any query, I will be happy to help, happy to answer. You can write to me, call me. Thank you everyone. Thank you so much.